let's draw the spoon here. So start to sketch on the top plane, this profile. Top, sketch. Bend over here a bit. Yeah, draw center line. I want to draw this center line, one center line, one center, and the other center line at the end there. So draw center line. Center line. Click. Okay, center line again. Center line. Okay, draw center line. Okay, dimension 23 and 105. Okay, now I'm going to start creating this arc first, R10. So I'm going to use enter point up. Make this up. So click here, make it vertical. Okay, dimension 10. Okay, next thing, I want to create this 40mm up. So 3 point up again. 3 point up. Okay, click. Okay. Click here. Make tension. I mentioned this one. 40. So I'm going to create a 17mm arc. This one I can use center point arc. Center point here. Okay. Okay. This point. Extension. Okay, dimension 17mm. Okay, now there's one more arc, R6. So I use 3 point arc. Okay, dimension, the center point arc, the center point to this center line is 9mm. The arc is 6mm. The arc is 6mm. 6mm. Okay, over here, I want to draw a R6mm arc. So, center point arc. Okay, maybe I extend this one. Okay, now draw this 600 mm up here. 3 point up. Click here. You can do 3 point up. Good point. Click. Okay. Click here. Click tangent. Okay. Dimension up. 600. And this one is supposed to be 6. Okay. Pick this point. At this point, again, and then, you know, and then, this point, and then, okay. Okay, now it's fully defined. Okay, I'm going to mirror over. So, mirror entity. Let me clear this one. Mirror this entity. So, make a copy, mirror about this one. Okay. Now it's done. Escape. Hey, quick. That's it, the sketch. Now on the front plane, I'm going to draw this profile. Front sketch. Okay, let me draw a 3 point out first. Another 3 point up. Quick, make tangent first. Okay, let me draw a center line, vertical line. Create another arc, 500 mm. 3 point up. Click this one, get a point, make tangent. Okay, dimension this one, 10 mm. Dimension the arc, 40. This arc here is dimension this arc here is 12 mm, and this one is very big, 500. Okay, let's dimension the length here to here, 84. Here to here, sure, and then 54 is here. Yeah. Click here. Click before. Let me drag the whole sketch over here. Okay, so I'm going to make a relationship here to the arc here. This point, click, control click, more time, click here, control click, give a clear direction. And here there's a distance of 54 here, done. This 54, I think it's wrong. Yeah, wait. 54 is from here to here, vertically now, 54. Okay, then from here to here, 144. Then this, this I Hey, this is 20, sorry. Double click. 20. This is 20. Okay, now the sketch is fully defined. Okay, let's see the sketch. So now we are going to create plane. One plane here, one plane is origin, one plane is here, another plane is over here. We'll go to right plane, click the plane command, I click this point. So I want plane. Plane 2 is the middle here. Middle here. Plane 2. So let's go to plane, right plane again. And let me click this point. Okay, now we have additional plane 1, plane 2. And now on the right plane we are going to sketch this. So I go to right plane. I'm going to go and up, 3 point up. Okay, make sure that this point and the line here coincident. Okay, let's make this 2 point horizontal. Give a 30. So now I want to create a fierce relationship between this up and this up here. So I need to create a point first. Create a point. in the middle. Okay. Control click here. Click this one. Control click the arc here. And ask for pierce relation. This 23 not enough because this dimension not important. So long as this arc is wider than the and this spoon profile, it's okay. Okay, next one, plane one, arrow 10. That's it. No plane one. Okay. Three point up. Again, click. Make this one in the center. Coincident. And don't click. It's not horizontal. Radius 10. And again, I have to create a point on this up here at the midpoint. Click the point. And this up here. Here. So. So now it's underdefined. Actually, I can define it by just giving normal to first. So I can stretch a bit, maybe bigger a bit, wider a bit. Maybe I give a dimension. It's 10. You can see that now it's fully defined. Then the next one is on plane 2, we are going to create another arc 40 mm. The plane 2, okay. So create arc. And open. 40. Okay. Click this one. In the center line here. Make it coincident. You know, I want to create a pierce relationship between this arc and this arc. You can create a point here. Okay, click this point. Control click the arc here. Here's relation. And now we want to create a boundary surface on these two curves. So go to surface. Boundary surface. Let me clear this one first. Okay. So I only want to select this portion, not the whole sketch. So I right click, select a manager, make sure you select this one, select group. Click this one. Say yes. Direction 2, select this one. Okay. On the preview, you can see that the surface is created. The next one. Okay, this one we're done, right? Done, right? So now we want to use surface floor for this portion here. So we have the surface floor. Lock the surface. Ready it. Okay. On the guide curve, two. I must go and maybe get up there. I click this patch and I say show. Now this sketch is show. Now I can go back to the face lock again. Right click, selection manager. Sorry. So after surface, just click here. Click the two profiles. Then for the guide curve, what is that? So then, so you follow the guide curve. The next one, the surface loss again. Okay. Okay, now I want to extend this portion. So to extend this portion, I've got to create a sketch on the front plane. Front sketch. Okay, let's cover entity, cover this line, cover entity again, cover this line. So trim the closer. Okay. Now I want to make this construction line. So I see the sketch. Okay, just now we have done this one, right? So we are going to boundary surface again to extend this part. Go to boundary surface. I like this. I like the sketch just now that we did. Okay. So the next step is you want to knit the whole surface. So go to knit surface, window, or okay. but now only one body. So now we are going to surface trim. Go to trim, trim surface, trim two. This will be this profile is my trim two. So remove. We are going to remove this part here, this part there. Okay. So the plane, I hide the plane. Make it later. Okay, now. Now the last part is to thicken this surface. So I go to thicken command. Okay, say 1.5 mm. Okay, on both sides. So click. Okay, so now the spoon is completed. So I can hide this. Okay, so now we have completed the spoon. So to add color, just go come over here and select any color that you want. Okay. So thanks for watching the video. See you in the next video. Thanks.